on the topic Destructuring the Way of Life by Making the Indian Constitution. Let's start. The making of Indian Constitution has its core of the well-being of a nation with the magnificent diversities of language, faith, custom, and differences also. If the country tried to run today, it would fail without constitution. Let's start with the story. Once there was a boy who was very poor, named Shan. He was of 12 years old, only 12 years old. But due to his bad luck, his mother was ill and his father was involved in drugs. His father sold all belongings for pot, wood and mortars. His father was illiterate and he was not an irresponsible person. Shan was very tense by seeing his poor condition. Shan's father sent him to an unknown factory for doing labor to earn money for his drugs. But Shan wanted to pot medicine for his mother. Shan did hard work all day and he was very he wanted to do study, but he hadn't enough money and time for his study. Shan's honor always beat him without any reason. Now, it was a miracle occurred. You know what was a miracle? It was formation of Indian Constitution in which many rights and duties are present. It is rightly said that the Indian Constitution formed the cornerstone of the nation, piloted by respected B.R. Ambedkar. There are 395 articles and 12 schedules are present in our Indian Constitution. There are 6 fundamental rights are included in our Indian Constitution. One of them, and the miracle for the Shan, was right against extradition, and it is third fundamental right, which is present in our Constitution. It guarantees dignity of an individual. By this right, any child needed employ below the age of 14 years. And if they employ due to some bad situations, some their owner or their employer should send him or her to school for 3 or 4 hours a day. So by these rules, Shan's owner also sent him to school and Shan was very happy and did hard work in his studies and he also did his study with full concentration. Now, we are surprised by seeing this, by listening this, that now Shan is an IPS officer by his hard work and by making of Indian Constitution. We should learn something from Shan's hard life. Be brave and should face all difficult circumstances in life. By this inspirational story, we can see that the making of Indian Constitution is a structure in the way of life of every person. Either he is poor, either he is rich, either he is Hindu, either he is Muslim or anything else. And as we know that our Indians are a developing country, and if these type of problems be solved, then our India will make a developed country definitely. And I want to listen from every person's mouth that our India is a developed country. I'm always waiting for this. Thanks and have a great day.
Good afternoon to all of you present here. My name is Uday Pratap Singh and I'm from 9th A class. So today I want to narrate a story on a great person's life. And she is none other than Maria Sharapova. She was Russian by nationality but she lives in USA. I will tell you the whole story. When she was just 9 years old, she went to USA, Florida with her father Yuri for her tennis training. But as we all know, a coin has two faces, head or tail. When she was on the way to her success, one thing stopped her, and it was the heart-wrenching separation from her mother. She missed her mother so terribly, and imagine a 9-year-old girl living, surviving without her mother. And just like the ragging done in the colleges, by the seniors to juniors, and the seniors of her also tortured her, humiliate her all the time. One day she was sleeping peacefully in her room. The senior come inside the room. "Hello, woke up. And the little girl woke up as she was ordered and commanded to do that. She woke up and asked that what happened. The senior said that you are lying and sleeping with peacefully. Don't you care about your room? Look at that. Do broom, do mop." She started crying because she needs her mother to do all that thing. So when she woke up, she do all the brooming from the mopping, and she was crying inside her heart. You will all think that she depressed, but not. Instead of letting all the depress her, she became more quietly determined and mentally tough. She also believed that all the insults and the humiliation than that to have put up steadfastly to pursue her dream. She thinks that she will become the number one in tennis, and she done that. With that toughness in her mind and physical endurance, mental endurance, she became number one tennis player in 2005. This girl taught me the real values of dedication, hard work, inspiration, motivation. And Maria was also a great patriot. One asked her that if you get a privilege or do something in Olympics, which country you will represent. She says confidently, "I am Russian by blood, but I am living right now in USA. But that don't mean I will work for USA." She confidently said, "If I had the opportunity to do something in Olympics, I would definitely going to represent Russia." This shows me to love your country, to love your nation. At the last, I want to say that stay strong, be happy, love yourself, accept yourself the way you are.
आज मैं आप सभी के सामने एक कहानी लेकर प्रस्तुत हुई हूँ, जिसका विषय है जूते की कीमत। कहने को तो जूते पाँव में डाले जाते हैं, लेकिन इसकी कीमत बहुत होती है। कीमत जाकर उनसे पूछो जिनको ये नसीब ही नहीं होते। एक बार एक परिवार था जिसमें दादा दादी, माँ बाप और एक बेटा था। जब बेटे की शादी हुई तो घर में बहू का प्रवेश हुआ। दो तीन साल के बाद उस घर में एक बेटी ने जन्म लिया। बेटी जब थोड़ी सी बड़ी हुई तो स्कूल में जाने लगी। जब स्कूल में जाने लगी तो उसका नृत्य की तरफ ध्यान गया और वह नृत्य करना चाहती थी। माँ बाप को इस बात से कोई आपत्ति नहीं थी, लेकिन दादा दादी सोचते थे नृत्य कर ये हमारे परिवार का नाम ही बिगाड़ देगी। और उसको समझाने के लिए एक दिन उन्होंने अपने जूते उतारकर उसे पहनने के लिए कहा। जब उसने पहने तो वह पूछ रही थी कि आप ये मुझे क्यों पहनने के लिए दे रहे हो। तो दादा दादी ने कहा, जैसे ये तुम्हें बड़े हैं, हमने तुमसे ज्यादा जिंदगी देखी है, हमें तुमसे ज्यादा पता है, नृत्य करके तुम कुछ नहीं कर सकती, बस सिर्फ हमारे परिवार का नाम ही बिगाड़ दोगी। तब वो लड़की का दिल अंदर से टूट गया और उसके पिता ने उसे एक चित्र बनाकर दिया, जिसमें ये दर्शाया गया था कि अगर हम सपनों को रंगीन आंखों से देखने की क्षमता रखते हैं तो उनका पूरा करने के हमें जुनून होना चाहिए। तब उसने और मेहनत की और नृत्य प्रतियोगिता में भाग लिया और वे तीसरे नंबर पर आए। तब वे रोने लगी क्योंकि वे अंदर से टूट चुकी थी। उसने सोचा मैं तीसरे नंबर पर आई हूँ, लेकिन उसके पिता ने फिर उसे वही चित्र दिखाया और उसने आगे से और मेहनत की और फिर भाग लिया और दूसरे नंबर पर आई। इस बार वे बहुत खुश थी और अगली बार उसने और मेहनत की और इतनी मेहनत की कि भारत की सबसे बड़ी प्रतियोगिता में भाग लिया और प्रथम स्थान पर आई। तब वे बहुत खुश थी और उसी खुशी में उसके घर में एक समारोह था, जहाँ सभी उसके रिश्तेदार और परिवार वाले एकत्रित थे। पत्रकारिता की ओर से कुछ पत्रकार आए और उन्होंने उसे पूछा कि इस सफलता का क्या राज है। तो उसने कोई भी जवाब बिना दिए दो चीजें उनके सामने लाकर रख दी, जिनमें से एक थे वो चित्र और दूसरे थे जूते। उसने कहा कि मेरी संघर्ष की शुरुआत इन जूतों से हुई और मेरे माँ बाप के हौसले से जो चित्र के द्वारा मुझे हौसला मिला, उससे मैंने सफलता प्राप्त की। भगवान से कजी से आशीष का सवाल पूछा तो नजर में एक परिंदा नजर आया। जब आंखें भरकर